Yeah, good morning, David. Good morning, Alex. And we are delighted, as you say, to interview, first on Bloomberg, the Colombian finance minister to have a little bit of a flavor of what a lot of the discussions will be about here for the IMF World Bank spring meetings. So, Mr. Cardenas, thank you so much for joining us. A lot of the talk will be on trade. A lot of the talk will be on tariffs. What does it mean for your region? You are the longest-serving finance minister in your region. Do you worry that a U.S.-China spat that turns ugly will hurt the Americas?
It will, and we're concerned. There's no doubt about that. There was a summit of Americas a week ago. The presidents from the region talked about this. This is a main concern for many reasons. One, the U.S. market. The U.S. market is very important for many of our economies, including Colombia. So any increase in tariffs in the U.S. is going to be costly. Also, the fact that there will be a trade war, a response from other countries, that could also mean protectionism in other parts of the world.
But do you think
where is all this going to end? There will be more products coming into our markets at lower prices. That's also something we worry about.
But, Minister, do you think this will be a trade war, or is this just a president that wants a deal? Is this just a president trying to rattle the cage so that the U.S. is better off without a trade war?
We don't know where it's going to end, and we don't know what the ramifications of this could be. It could begin between the U.S. and China, but others may come in. And the world economy is going to be affected because there'll be more products that cannot enter the U.S. market or cannot enter the Chinese market if there is protectionism in China that will end up elsewhere, including our own economy. So our producers are concerned. I think, as with all trade wars...
But commodity producers or coffee producers?
Well, not necessarily commodity producers. Manufacturers, agricultural producers in general, because they are concerned that for their economies, for their own businesses individually, open markets are fundamental. And by the way, Colombia is an open economy as well, and many products from China, from the U.S., end in Colombia. So it's going to be disruptive.
If you look at the region, and then I will go on to Colombia and some of the finances there, but if you look